Welcome back to Let's Play Snatcher, Blind, on the Sega CD. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We are headed towards Freddy Nielsen's apartment. We're coming from Ivan Rodriguez's apartment. He is not the Snatcher, so that it must be Freddy is the other result for the composite photo we made from the description that Isabella gave us, who followed, what's his name? John Gibson, now deceased, of the Junkers, and he followed him and apparently was one of the Snatchers. There's a male and female. Ooh. It could be both of them. It could be him and his wife. Not sure if we ever get a definitive description of the wife. But anyway, now heading to Freddy Nielsen's apartment. We're going to regret this, because he's probably going to kill us, because my controls are not that responsive, and I'm not that quick yet at shooting these snatchers, insectors, whatever. But I have a recent save, so let's go for it. This is Freddy Nielsen's building. Now this guy is a taxi driver. Lives here with his wife. According to data, he lives on the second floor, apartment 202. Yes, that matches what I wrote down. Well, this is our last suspect. Will he be the one we're looking for? There's a plate which reads Dormitory Okamoto. The design and atmosphere of the building is no doubt popular with women. With women, why necessarily? Opulence? It's a rather lively neighborhood, isn't it? The building is right on the main street. Quite convenient. This is like day and night compared to Ivan's place. This area actually looks safe. Which means it's probably not. There used to be a tube liner station around this area. It's probably a throwback to that. It's a rather lively neighborhood, isn't it? Yes. The sewer system is apparently incomplete. Steam is billowing up from underground pipes. So that means there are underground passages around here. The old subway system known as the tube liner used to run directly underneath this area. There's no doubt why work on the sewers was delayed. That's a remnant from before the automatic traffic system was completed. Now it's being used for advertising. If there are still traffic signals left, then it must be a rather old neighborhood. The building is sided with imitation bricks. It's built so that one can reach the second floor from the outside. It's a two-story traditional style apartment building. You can see the window for number 202. As you guys may or may not know, I pull the string until there's no more results. There are turbo cycles and pedestrians moving everywhere. Would snatchers actually live in an area like this where they would be seen? At night, sure. They're indistinguishable, pretty much. Unless you scan them, and most people don't have equipment to scan people like that. For a residential area, there are several stores and parks quite nearby. The cover has been sealed to prevent accidents, since it's not used anymore. The manhole has Neo Kobe's symbol on it. It appears quite old. As in other districts, the traffic signals no longer perform their original function. Sensors and crime prevention cameras are buried here. Room 202, and preemptively save here. This is apartment 202, the second floor, right? Let's head up. This is it, apartment 202. Don't forget what happened at Ivan's. Be very careful, Gillian. I'll try. It says 202, Freddy and Lisa Nielsen. What if they participate in the Nielsen ratings? Nielsen appears on the nameplate. The door has a peephole. It's a very well-built metal door. So, I think I can go out front is back where we were. There's no mistake, this is definitely Nielsen's apartment. The nameplate has an IC chip for data confirmation purposes. There's no mistake. The door is locked. I read motion. Someone is inside. Here comes that song I love. I love this crap. It's no doubt an electronic lock system. Anti-crime systems are installed as well. Oh, we can no longer go back out front, I notice. I expect trouble. Alright, I'll knock. There's no answer. I wonder if he's really not home. We detected movement, remember? Someone's in there. I definitely picked up motion. Hey, in there! Open up! I'm a junker. I've got a few questions to ask you. There's no answer, is there? I'm a junker. Open the door. Maybe they cannot hear us. Let's show the ID. I'm a junker. Is anybody home? Total silence. Apparently nobody is home. So what are we picking up? A dog or something? I think they just don't want to let us in. I can't show anything else. What do we do now? Who is it? Alright, they're answering. They're talking now. I heard a voice. Yes, I know. Me too. It said, who is it? Huh? Hard of hearing?
A junker? All right, just a minute.
Gillian, please use extreme caution.
The wife?
Huh? A woman?
With green hair. I'm with the Junker Agency. Is this the home of Freddy Nielsen? Lisa says yes it is. And you are? I'm his wife. You know, we saw her data on Jordan. Yes, I know. Exactly, what can I do for you? Okay. I was expecting a fight. Pretty good looking. Cool hair. Well, investigator, you have good taste in women, Lisa says. What's with that look on your face? You don't believe me, do you? Lisa says. If you want to scan me, you'll have to show me a scanning warrant. Without one of those, junkers can't scan civilians. I know the law. just looking at you. If you don't have a scanning warrant, I'll have to ask you to stop that. It's a rather nice room, well kept and tidy. What do you want with us, investigator? The interior design points to someone with good taste. What's this? There's some kind of map on the wall. This map just doesn't go with the rest of the interior, does it? Gillian says. There's nothing on the wall besides the map. It's a rather old 2D printed map. What is this a map of? That's not Neo Kobe, is it? I guess she doesn't feel like volunteering any information. My apologies, but I'm afraid I need to investigate you, ma'am. I'll handle it, Gillian says. You always say that when we're questioning women. What the? Just where do you think you're touching? What do you want with us, investigator? I've had a bad toothache since this morning. I'm really not in a very good mood. Is that why she has her hand like that? I don't see anything unusual. She's the only one in the room. There's no sign of anyone else. What are you talking about? This is a map of the city of Moscow. Moscow, huh? That place has been little more than a ghost town since the catastrophe. Yes, but this map was no doubt produced before the catastrophe. The map is marked in one spot. It says Kremlin. Interesting. What is your business here? Let's ask her things before our regular talk. About Gibson. Gibson? Who's that? I have no idea. Freddy? I'd like to ask you about Freddy. Has something happened to my husband? I didn't actually ask her anything yet. Why, has he been arrested or something? She's not volunteering information. Would you explain exactly what you mean? Ask about Outer Heaven. Have you ever been to Outer Heaven? Who's that? Could you tell what you're here for? What do you want with us, investigator? She has a lot of questions, more than we do. Have you ever heard that your husband has been there? I don't know. Is that some kind of dirty nightclub? Don't make me keep repeating myself. I have a terrible toothache. Is that what you came to ask about, investigator? What's this map? I don't really know. My husband bought it and stuck it there about 4 months ago. I don't really know. What? My husband a snatcher? Where did you get a story like that? I have a montage photo I'd like you to look at. We're just talking about the map. Never mind. Can I take a look at that? Can I take a look at that montage? Alright. Let's, talk. Freddy as a suspect. As a matter of fact, we're investigating your husband on a suspicion that he may be a snatcher. Freddy? Freddy a snatcher? That's ridiculous. I can't believe that. Can I take a look at that montage? She really wants to see the montage. Sneeze? Have you experienced any sneezing lately, even though you don't have a cold? The guy at Outer Heaven was sneezing. I haven't had a cold yet this year. Why would we ask about sneezing? I'm in very good health. What does that have to do with anything? Yeah, what does it have to do with anything? Alright, so we're gonna show her stuff. Show her my junker ID. Alright, I believe you. there some problem with that? Gibson's photo. What's that? Well, that's a picture of a person. I don't want to show the montage yet. I'll do that last. Chess piece? Some problem with the chess piece. Okay, she doesn't know anything more about the chess piece than she would the sunscreen. Apparently. Anyway. What's that? That is disc. It is disc. A disc for you. Alright, let's show the photo. The montage photo. That's my husband. I can't believe my husband is a snatcher. There must be some mistake. Again. I can't believe it. This montage photo was produced using a computer from the testimony of witnesses at a nightclub. Well, it does look like my husband, so? It could be just a coincidence, of course. All these questions are rather annoying. I've had this bad toothache since this morning, you know. It's been attached with tape. Can we remove the map? That's why we need you to tell us about your husband. He's out right now. I'm not sure what time he'll be back. Have you noticed anything strange about your husband lately? Well, now that you mention it, lately he hasn't been in the mood to, well, you know. Could you be more specific? You see, he drives a manned taxi, but lately he's been taking walks at night without going to work. Walks? At night? Yep. Ghost sound. I think of that as the ghost sound. Doo-doo-doo. Recent behavior, health, and occupation. Well, now that you mention it, he has been acting a little strange lately, but a snatcher? Plus he's a cab driver. He's not exactly a VIP. But maybe he does drive a lot of VIPs around. Yeah, toothache. Have you noticed any change in your husband's body or health recently? No, his appetite's as big as ever. No, nothing. How about his skin? Anything odd? His skin? Well, I haven't seen much of it lately, but I'm sure it's fine. He was sick last year, but he's been strong as a horse lately. Yep, stronger than a human being, I guess. Your husband is a taxi driver, right? Is it one of those underground cabs? A black taxi? Are you trying to frighten me? So it is a black taxi, right? Yes, he drives a black taxi. But so what? They'll probably be legalized in April, right? So what's the problem? That's not what we're worried about, ma'am. If your husband is a black taxi driver, then there are no records of his working hours, right? In other words, the only way to establish an alibi for him is to use... something... by the testimony of others? Oh. That sentence is all screwed up. On Thursday around 8 p.m., was your husband at home or working? Thursday? Oh, that's right. That was one of his days off. He was home. He was watching the launch of the first colonial expedition to Mars, the Beagle Jerusalem, on TV. Are you sure about that? Yes, but that evening I went over to a friend's house. I wasn't with him all night. My friend's brother is the pilot of the Beagle, you know?
Hmm. This isn't enough to prove that our Freddy Nielson is a snatcher.
True. Without more evidence, we cannot get a scanning warrant.
We'd like to take a look in your bathroom, if you don't mind.
Oh, you need to use the bathroom?
No, we'd like to investigate your bathroom.
Right.
Really? Whatever. Please, go right ahead.
Someone get that light switch. Thanks, Metal. This is Freddy's bathroom. Go right ahead, Lisa says. Check anything you want. I'll be out here. Alright, looking around. A very attractive bathroom, and sparkling clean. This bathtub just doesn't compare with that thing at Ivan's place. It's filled with water. There's something funny about the bathtub. There must be some kind of bath crystals or soap in the water. It's an unusual color. Yep, something funny about it. We'll investigate it in a moment. Look, you can see a reflection in the mirror. Glad to see I'm not a vampire. Jeez, I've always been such a handsome devil. There are a number of bottles on the shelf. As usual, homes with women living in them always have nice bathrooms. Yeah, I guess we tend to be more clean, right? Up to investigate now. It's a very attractive system bath unit. I'd like to try taking a nice hot bath in a place like this. Metal, you'd probably rust or short out or something. Okay, not investigating a bathtub just yet. The mirror has electrical wires within it, which heat up to prevent fogging. Interesting. Gillian, a secret compartment on the back of the mirror doesn't exist. Oh god. Got a robot with a sense of humor. There was no faucet. This is an unusual bathtub. Rather odd for a system bathtub, isn't it? What's a system bathtub? I can detect no residue on the surface of the tub. It has been cleaned very well. I wonder where the water is drained from this. You got me. Investigate the shelf, see what bottles we are. There's no secret compartment on the mirror or in the cabinet. The shelf seems to be completely ordinary. So there were bottles there. I'm looking for... what do you call it? Sunscreen. Jeez, I guess we're going back to the living room. Might be a surprise out there. Let's see. Gillian, let's look for evidence of snatchers here. I don't see anything. Wait a minute. Haven't we seen this bottle someplace before? Just how many times do I have to look at something? I don't see anything else about it. Now that you mention it, the bottle on the shelf looks familiar. Sunscreen. What's this? That's the same container as the one we found at Jean's. Yep, and that's the logo from Plato's, whatever you call it, which is a weird version of the Konami logo. I will analyze the contents of the bottle. There's no mistake, this is sunscreen. Sunscreen in the middle of the winter, huh? And it looks like it's been used recently, too.
There's no mistake. Freddy Nielson is a snatcher. Gillian, with this much evidence, there will be no difficulty getting a scanning warrant.
We've got you now, snatcher scum.
So, you figured it out, huh?
Oh god, it's her!
Who's that?
It's Lisa! Draw your gun.
Know all about us, do you, Junker?
That's why she had her hand there.
That wound!
Jean did that to her.
Oh.
Die, Junker!
Never! Oh god. We did it. Well, that was easier than the insectors. Thought it was gonna be harder.
Jeez, those things don't go down easy.
Nasty.
So, this is a snatcher, huh?
I certainly hope it's dead.
Now, what's interesting is on the original, I guess, version of this game, on the PC 88, I believe it was. The breasts were exposed. So they, for the worldwide release, they, censored that for the Sega CD. Let us look at the remains. It appears to be dead. Damn, those things are tough as heck. Its functions appear to have been completely terminated. So that skin tissue we found under Gibson's nails came from this woman, huh? Now, makes me wonder if Freddy Nielsen is also a snatcher, or he's fine and just completely unaware of his wife.
So it was Lisa and Freddy who killed Jean.
Freddy, that's right.
Almost
so where's he?
We can contact the junk collection team later. Let's get out of this apartment for now. We're outside now.
What the? A light just came on. There's Oops. Not supposed to be anybody in there.
Perhaps Freddy has returned.
There's only one entrance, and we're standing right next to it.
Yeah.
How did he get in there?
Shall we investigate?
That's funny. I could have sworn it wasn't locked. It's an electronic lock. Someone must have activated it. This appears to be the only way in or out of the apartment. There are no other ways in or out of the apartment. This is a standard electronic lock. I can open this without too much difficulty. I'm reading motion. Someone is in there. Yeah, saving. Let's not yell or knock. Let's see if we can get the drop on Freddy, apparently.
Metal, open it.
Okay, now establishing Alpha 1 link. Link made. Executing search for lock code of apartment 202.
Hurry it
up! Exciting.
just a bit longer. I'm in Alpha One's maintenance records for the MR district. Lock code found. Now opening the door.
Good work.
And we find... nobody yet. I don't see Freddy anywhere. Doesn't appear to be in this room. He's in the bathroom, grabbing his sunscreen. There's no sign of anyone in this room. There's nothing on my infrared sensors either. It's in the same condition as it was a few minutes ago. It hasn't been touched. Lisa's remains do not appear to have been touched. I'm not picking up any sounds. But then... motion. I read motion coming from the bathroom. It's the only other room. Yeah. Gonna have to do it. Saving again. I know. Cheesy. Metal, you ready? Let's go. Okay. This is Freddy's bathroom.
Huh? The bathtub is empty.
Oh.
That thing was filled with water just a few minutes ago.
Down to the sewer system.
I read motion. This room.
Damn. Where is he?
Gillian, behind you.
Gillian, aim at what? I've had it. Did I shoot myself? Oh!
That was close. You're lucky I was here to save your skin.
Who are you?
What?
Me? Random Hajio.
Oh!
Bounty hunter.
What?
Bounty hunter?
I've heard of him.
Yes, Gillian, a bounty hunter. As the junker profession is so dangerous, their numbers have fallen dramatically over the past few years.
There's only one of us.
The government decided to put a price on Snatcher's heads in order to encourage private citizens to cooperate in the effort to track them down. Naturally, these bounty hunters must register with the authorities.
You said your name's Random, right? What did you do? Follow me here?
Yeah, you got it. Investigations aren't my style. You track them down... I take him out.
You have the legal obligation to state your bounty hunter registration number. Please do so now, immediately.
BH75001 Random Hajio. That's RANDOMHAJILE.
BH75001 Random Hajio. That's confirmed. I officially recognize you as a legal bounty hunter. Wow. Gillian, records indicate that he has already disposed of 3 Snatchers just this month. Counting Freddy, that makes 4.
4?
Jeez.
I've been at this a lot longer than you have. Just relax, rookie.
I didn't need your help.
So, Junker Boy, let me give you a little tip. You might already know, but Snatcher's weak point is their artificial skin. If they sit out in the sun too long, they get cancer.
I know.
That's why they set up a hospital to treat this little problem of theirs. You find it. You can take them out. Roots and all.
Where did you get all your information? Wait a sec. You stole it from Gibson, didn't you?
That's not really important. But now that Gibson's out of the picture, I need you to get busy.
I track them down and you junk them. Is that the idea?
Anyhow, it seems Gibson found that hospital. He must have left behind some information about it.
What do you mean, seems? Don't you know anything about it?
Hey, investigations are your job, right?
I owe you one, Random.
Yeah, I'll get it out of you later. See ya, Junker Boy.
I don't like him. He stole my kill. We got all the XP.
Snatcher-controlled hospital, eh? There's bound to be more than a few of them in there.
Kill stealer, kill stealer. Act 1 end. Would you like to save your investigation up to this point? Let's say yeah. Gonna do that. So I think this is a good place to leave off. So next episode, we will start up Act 2. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.